Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 6.3 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abacus. In example 6.3, we use computational micromechanics to calculate the shear modulus G13 of the composite. For that we use a representative volume element, RVE, as shown here. The circular regions are fibers, and the rest is matrix. Boundary and constraint conditions are applied to enforce periodicity. The dimensions A1, A2, A3, of the RVE, are in the textbook. Fiber direction 1 is aligned with Z, transverse direction 2 is aligned with X, and lamina thickness direction 3 is aligned with Y. To build the RVE, we start by creating a volume, 3D, deformable, solid, extrusion. We draw the cross section on the XY plane, with dimensions 2A2 by 2A3, then extrude it through the thickness 2A1, in the Z direction. Next we partition the fibers from the volume. We start by sketching the fiber cross section on the face of the volume. The radius of the fibers is 3.5. Now we partition the cell by sweeping the face sketch through the thickness of the cell. Now we create properties for the fiber and the matrix. Both are isotropic, but the resulting composite is not. Now create a section for each region. Region fiber, and region matrix. Now assign the sections to their regions on the solid model. Now assign the part to an instance. Next, create a linear perturbation step. Now edit the field output requests, to save the integration point volume, because we need it later, to calculate the average stress, and thus the effective modulus of the composite. Now we define the boundary conditions to enforce periodicity on the RVE. Clamp the bottom, except along X. Apply shear YZ equals 1, by applying a displacement U3 equals the height of the RVE. And symmetry on the faces with normal along X. Now a tie constraint, to ensure that only YZ shear happens, as a result of U3 applied at the top. Note that it must be applied to node regions, not to surfaces. Otherwise, pure shear is not enforced. The distance is 2A1, which is the thickness of the volume, and the distance between the master and slave surfaces. Now we mesh, being careful to choose hex elements and sweep meshing, so that every node on the master surface has a corresponding one on the slave surface, with same coordinates except for Z. This is a requirement of the node region definition of the master and slave surfaces. Here you can see front and back views of the mesh, annotated with red arrows to show that they mirror each other, so that each node on the master surface also exists at the same XY location on the slave surface, thus allowing node region-based tie constraints. Now create a job, submit it, and when completed, click results. For results, let's look at the shear strain E23, which really is EYZ, if you look at the triad on the figure. It is not uniform, and concentrated in the matrix. Next we calculate the effective G23, actually GYZ according to the triad in the video, and G12 according to the notation of the book. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook by following the link in the description. Thank you.